Welcome to Loop TV. I'm your host, Gene Munster, along with Greg Swan today. Our topic is augmented reality and advertising. We all know that for these segments, these businesses, these new techs to really take hold, advertising needs to be a part of it. That's what Greg is going to talk to us about. He is the head of digital at Fallon. Fallon, for those techie people who don't know much about advertising, has been around almost 40 years. They have been the champion of iconic ad campaigns from some of the biggest brands. And not only that, they have been pioneers in the digital space as well. In the late 90s, they came out with BMW films. Check them out on YouTube. They are wonderful examples of embracing a medium. Back at the time, people thought they were crazy for doing video on the internet. Fallon moved forward. So having somebody like Greg here to help enlighten us about the technology, about the future of advertising, is most helpful. Welcome, Greg. I'm going to jump in, ask you a question right out of the gate here. The topic, again, augmented reality. When you think about it, and you're looking at a lot of different tech, I would guess, a lot of different ways to head of digital, where does AR fit into the pantheon of projects that are on your plate?
Well, thanks so much for having me, Gene. It's really great to be here. I'm a big fan of Loop Ventures.
Thank you.
And I love augmented reality. So what a great topic for today.
It is a great topic. Before we start.
So part of my role at Fallon and working with big brands to think about how they use technology to reach their customers is looking kind of around the corner. What's the next big thing going to be? And augmented reality was that next big thing a few years ago. So we invested in a Microsoft HoloLens and we started learning how we're going to code and how do you understand where the floor is and where the person is and how do you digitally map a face to put a filter over it, all of those things. And today, as we look at 2021, so much of that is plug and play. So much of that is just native to the tools, and consumers, they might not know the word augmented reality, but they have experienced it, whether they've watched it on video or experienced it with themselves, which is vastly different than where we were 5 years ago. And as I look kind of in the next 5 years, I think this is going to be a topic we continue to focus on.
Let me pause there. You mentioned that when HoloLens came out, what is it like in a creative digital tech agency when these are announced? For example, when Snap comes out with their glasses, do you care about it? Do you wait for Snap to send you them? What's it like internally when these new technologies start to pop up?
So I think that the best digital marketers are excited when there's a new thing. They're not like, oh, there's another thing I have to learn. They're like, oh my gosh, I got to get my hands on that. And what that means is you cannot wait for a competitor or the companies to get around to sending them. So like, so here's my Snap spectacles.
Oh, nice, there we go. Right?
So we got 10 of the very first pair in the world. And we immediately took one pair to our client and then had this other pair sitting around and we're looking for an opportunity to do something. And we ended up partnering with the Minnesota Wild hockey team to put these on players and on the Zamboni, on the ice, and filming first person point of view, creating content, sharing that to garner outrageous attention. Now, was the video that much different than a GoPro? Absolutely not. Okay. But because it was filmed through a new piece of technology, you can earn unreasonable amounts of attention for your brand.
I'm getting a master's in advertising here, so keep going.
So when you ask, like, are you excited when HoloLens comes out or when there's a new thing? Like, yes, we're excited, but not just because we're geeks. We are excited because we want to experiment with that technology and figure out what's the technology, how does the design work, what's the utility, and then how can we use that with our brands to earn an unreasonable amount of unfair attention using creativity?
So it's good to hear the perspective too, that you don't need things to be tried and true and tested before you dive in. You're right there. It makes a ton of sense. And when we think about some of the variations of AR so far, filters is a great example, Pokemon, yeah. Those are all out there. But I'm going to fast forward and take kind of some of these subtle use cases today, where, as you said, like, people may not even realize they're using AR, and fast forward to Tim Cook's case when he talks about, we're going to look back at AR and Marvel. And this idea that we'll have glasses or some form of wearable contact lenses, perhaps, and we're walking around and different information is kind of being fed to us about the real world. We're looking at a tree and perhaps there is identification of the tree, the genome of the tree, whatever it may be, that world of having all this stuff thrown at me as I'm walking around, I'm a big tech geek, that doesn't really sound appealing to me. Tell me different. How do you think about us getting more comfortable with this AR-enabled world?
It's a good question. So we are completely used to Snapchat and Instagram filters that turns my face into a puppy, or it projects hearts all the way around. And you know, now they're on Facebook and TikTok, and we're completely used to that. We're used to Pokemon Go and understanding that there could be a Pikachu right here. If you hold your phone up, you could see it. We are used to real-time translation, where I can hold my phone up to a sign in Mandarin and it will give me the English instruction. That's all augmented reality.
I'm good with all that stuff. So far,
we just don't call it that. But Microsoft, Apple, Facebook, Snapchat, they all have patents for smart glasses. Okay. They're pushing them, and they are coming. And these are Amazon Echo Frames, so these aren't augmented reality glasses.
Oh,
they're
nice.
Hearable glasses.
They look
but
great.
They look pretty good. You wouldn't know, right? So I'm both a futurist and a historian. So I want to understand where we were with Google Glass and what went wrong. And then I want to look at where we're going in the future. And so from an advertising perspective, our game is attention, right? Our game is, how can I capture your attention and offer you both fun and utility in a way that helps me sell a product without abusing your privacy or annoying you? And we don't always get that right in advertising. So if you think about a world.
Let's pause there. Yeah. Let's talk about the annoying piece there, because that is something that catches people's attention. I understand that advertising, when there's an entertainment aspect, people want to be advertised to if there's an entertainment component to it. And on the annoying side, so walk me through, I'm walking down the street, all this stuff is hitting me. Are we going to embrace that, do you think, or are we going to have some pushback to that?
So I don't like pop-up ads. I don't like banner ads that are targeting me with content that are not anything I would ever want to buy.
By the way, I'm so glad to hear someone in advertising say this, because it just makes me think advertising is moving in the right direction. Keep going.
So let's say that I have augmented reality smart glasses, which I think will be a thing, at least in the next decade. I think it'll be sooner than that. So, which means I could be walking down the street and there could be a digital layer on everything, which therefore means there might be ads that I can turn off, or I can earn, or I can pay to not see.
Okay.
So, you know, if you think about other, the example I like to use is if you went to Times Square, New York City, 100 years ago, and you just met someone on the street and you said, did you know every inch of this entire cross streets will be covered in ads and blinking lights and big speakers and all these things competing for your attention, and you showed them a picture of what it looks like today, they would never believe you.
Yeah, they may not even be able to understand what a display is.
Let alone, so almost all of them now are digital billboards. So they can change over and over again. Coca-Cola has a 3D billboard with, like, I don't remember the number, 300 little squares that go in and out. My previous agency worked on them. So to try to understand in the next 10 plus years that you could walk down the street and that there could be all these things competing for your attention,
right?
It's plausible. Now, your question, though, was...
So the idea is that we got good with Times Square. Who knows what our appetite... I may be an outlier here. Longer term, we're just going to get used to it.
Well, somewhat. Also, I think there'll be natural pushback. And I'm not personally excited about having nature or having everything turn into an ad. However, as a student... and a purveyor of the marketing communications, I am interested in how those new mediums could work. But the public will push back. And we saw that with Google Glass too. Like, there were privacy implications and some some bad PR on Google Sense that
real bad.
That the public wouldn't allow that to go. And I think that's one of the reasons Apple hasn't launched their glasses or visors. You saw Mark Zuckerberg said for this coming year, Facebook probably will launch something. I think they're going to take their time and try to do it right. And then we'll be right behind them in those first few days, knowing everything we know about ARKit on Apple, AR Core on Android, everything we've learned around within Unity and Steam and VR, and how we're going to build digital experiences that help you in the physical world experience something.
I'm going to jump in there and give everybody a baseline here in terms of where things are at from a tech perspective. Is, as you said, Facebook, Apple, Google, those are probably the three companies that are pushing this. They will make this a reality. Facebook has the only one of the big those big three that have said that they're actually going to have some form of a wearable. They have not given a time frame to that. We think that it is most likely in 2025 and kind of loosely lines up when we're expecting Apple to come out with their glasses. And then as a quick side point is that the ability to map AR is gotten much more advanced with the more recent iPhone 12 Pro. That comes with a LiDAR camera. It's the same thing that's in your autonomous driving car. It is world-facing, so it's on the back of the phone. That's a big deal for AR geeks because that means it's going to be more accurate in terms of placing those digital assets on the real world. So we're making progress on that. We're going to jump to the end here. Let's jump 5 years ahead here and walk us through what the advertising experience is going to be with what are the models that you see most likely emerging around once this is kind of mainstream around advertising and AR.
I think that we should anticipate customization at a massive rate. And so if you think about a modern TV commercial that runs on CBS at 7 p.m. on television, if that's running on broadcast, that's not targeted to you. But if you're watching that online or through like Hulu or Slingbox or YouTube, increasingly that is targeted to you. Now think about a social media ad that is only targeted to you because it knows you. And so if you kind of take the span between those two things and then apply it to lenses in the real world that would have both the context of who you are and where you are and what you're interested in, it's only a matter of time until there are ads there and they're
targeted. So what would it look like? I'm walking in the store, I have these glasses on. What's the experience I'm going to feel?
When you're waiting in a checkout line, there's magazines and there's chewing gum and there's things competing for your attention. That could happen with glasses. I think we'll do it right if it's not an annoyance. I think we'll do it right if people don't hate it and want it to turn off. If it adds value and it's customized to your life, then I think you would be well suited for success in that area.
Got it. So are we going to see AR coupons? We're walking through a store and different promotions will pop up.
You might see in the same way today where there's a value exchange. If you download a brand's app, then you can have access to deals.
Got
that it. If you sync your glasses with your app in the store, it would unlock something. You could see that. And especially with Amazon's checkoutless stores, the Amazon Go stores, you could see some real interesting innovations coming, especially, you know, 5 years from now is a lifetime in technology.
That's a great place to leave it for now. 5 years is a lifetime. Accelerating tech trends undoubtedly will power AR forward. I'm glad to know that smart people are being careful about that trade-off between the amount of ads we get versus the experience. Thank you, Greg. I learned a lot today. Count us both in the group that wants to advance AR. Final question off the main topic here. I see the Simpsons behind you there. Quickly, favorite Simpson character before we go?
Oh, Homer.
Homer. Okay, enough said. On behalf of Homer, Greg, and I, this is Loop TV, and bye for now.